Yo, what's up guys, it's T-Bag. Lately, I've been checking out a lot of videos about the Peacekeeper. You know, the super secret pistol in Battlefield 1 that you can only unlock after doing some crazy Easter egg challenges and whatnot. And I thought to myself, you know how hard it is to unlock this gun if you start from scratch? If you haven't done any of the Omen Easter egg challenges, you better give up because unlocking the Peacekeeper, it takes too long, it takes so much effort, it's actually crazy. But then I thought to myself, what are the hardest guns to unlock in Battlefield? Not just Battlefield 1, but looking across all Battlefield titles. There are some guns out there that can only be unlocked after doing certain things. So I decided, you know what? Let's do a video on that. I think there will be a lot of fun. So here is the top 5 most difficult to unlock guns in Battlefield history. Let's start this off with Battlefield Hardline. On number 5, we have the Syndicate gun from Battlefield Hardline, the Battlefield game that came before Battlefield 1. The Syndicate gun is basically the Lewis gun, and it was the first clue before Battlefield 1 was revealed that we would go back in time to World War 1. The Syndicate gun was part of the final DLC for Battlefield Hardline called Betrayal. Now, personally, I haven't played it that much, but I did check out some of the guides on how to unlock this gun. It's not as hard as some of the other guns on this list, but you do need to have 4 extra people to unlock this gun. So if you don't have any friends like me, this assignment becomes pretty difficult to do. Now, this is not gonna be a guide video, so I'm gonna make a long story short and tell you the grand scheme of how you unlock these guns. So for the Syndicate gun, first you needed to unlock the Mammoth gun, which is kind of a triple barreled shotgun that is locked in a frame in a secret room in one of the DLC maps for Battlefield Hardline. After that, you needed to bring 4 friends to a specific part of a map and let them stand in a specific spot. Your friends needed to equip certain guns from World War 1 that came with the expansion packs. A 5th guy needed to stand somewhere with the Mammoth gun, and when all 4 people with the World War 1 guns would activate some kind of a switch all at the same time, a secret doorway would uncover itself and way below you would find the Syndicate gun, aka the Lewis gun. So in terms of effort, it's not that difficult to do, but you did have to gather 4 friends. You needed to unlock the Mammoth gun, and you had to have the 4 World War 1 era guns that came with the expansion packs for Battlefield Hardline. So all in all, pretty elaborate, but not nearly as bad as the next 4. So on number 4 we have Battlefield 3's M1911 Aztec. The Aztec is basically the regular M1911, but equipped with both tactical light and a suppressor, which was not possible for the M1911 in Battlefield 3. Also, prior to this unlock, the Aztec was a developer only weapon, kinda like the C96 Export and the Howda Sweeper in Battlefield 1. So unlike the Syndicate gun in Battlefield Hardline, the M1911 Aztec was actually a pain in the ass. Obviously, as always, you needed to have all DLCs and complete, I believe, 5 different annoying assignments. First, you needed to destroy an enemy helicopter with the new AA Jeep that came with the latest DLC in Battlefield 3. The next assignment you had to complete was about the new Capture the Flag game mode. And as far as I can tell by watching Jack's video, the next assignment could be very annoying because you also needed to kill people in specific ways with an airdrop IFV. And at the time, it was pretty difficult to get and, you know, just all around annoying. You needed to have a lot of luck on your side to get into the required vehicles. After that, it wasn't too difficult. You just needed to destroy some vehicles and get some headshots with pistols, and then you would unlock the M1911 Aztec. Pretty cool gun. I don't think many people have it, but then again, it wasn't too difficult. It was mostly annoying. On number 3, we could go with either or, but I chose to put in the Phantom Bow from Battlefield 4 on number 3. Now, I'm telling you, the top 3 is pretty insane. So first of all, the Phantom Bow. For the people who unlocked the Phantom Bow the OG way, you know what I'm talking about. The Phantom Bow was a weapon in Battlefield 4 that you only unlocked after doing the Phantom program, kind of like the Peacekeeper in Battlefield 1. The mastermind JJJU created this Easter egg hunt, and it's just absolutely mental. Like the Peacekeeper in Battlefield 1, before even starting this assignment, to unlock this weapon, you needed to complete all previous ones. So again, if you were starting from scratch, this was gonna be a pain in the ass. So after you completed the first assignments, you needed to find some secret dog tags from the Final Stand DLC. These were scattered around the maps and they had different spawning locations, so it was pretty annoying to find them. Not only that, 3 other friends needed to each equip one of the dog tags. So again, you needed to have friends, and that's why I never unlocked it. After all that, you could enter a secret room with a force field that locks the Phantom Bow. In order to get to this room, you needed to meet all requirements, so all 4 people needed to equip different secret dog tags, equip the Phantom camo for your weapon and soldier, as well as completing all previous assignments. Luckily, to access and disable the force field, you needed to enter a code that was already deciphered by the Easter Egg community. So this code was not unique per server. It was a set code, and that's why the Phantom Bow is on number 3. After you disable the force field, the bow is yours to use. Now in my opinion, this is pretty hard to unlock, especially since you need to have done all previous assignments. So the people who actually did this back in the day, they were pretty pissed when they found out that the Phantom Bow was made public for everyone in Battlefield 4. I believe when Operation Outbreak was released, which was the community map, you could just go to an open box in the middle of the field and simply pick up the bow, and bam, you unlocked it. So there's a pretty fair chance that the Peacekeeper will be made public for every Battlefield 1 player, only time will tell. Now on number 2 we have Battlefield 1's Peacekeeper. Just recently the community found out how to unlock it, and that it's actually a pretty cool gun. Not only the animations are extremely cool, but also the gun itself, it packs a mean punch. Now the reason this is on number 2 is because, I mean come on, you already know. Morse code, Morse code, Morse code. In Battlefield 1, Morse code was the way to go. There were so many Morse code messages, which was just a pain in the ass to decipher and stuff like that. Now, most of you probably already know the hell you needed to go through in order to unlock the Peacekeeper, so I'm not gonna go over that. I am gonna say that I did one of the requirements to unlock the escalation skin for the Browning machine gun, and yeah, that was pretty annoying, so I'm gonna leave it at that. But on number 1, the hardest, most difficult, impossible to unlock gun in Battlefield history is the F2000. From Battlefield Bad Company 1. I'm gonna tell you why. This is without a doubt the rarest gun in Battlefield's history. Only a fraction of the Battlefield Bad Company 1's player base has the F2000. See, the F2000 was part of the Find All 5 program. This was a thing before and during Bad Company's launch to unlock exclusive weapons. You could unlock the F2000, the M60, the Uzi, the QBU-88 and the USAS-12. Now unlocking them was fairly simple. To unlock the QBU-88, all you needed to do was pre-order the game and you would get the code for that gun with your disc. For the M60 you needed to register yourself for the Battlefield newsletter. So far not that hard. For the Uzi all you needed to do was download and play the Battlefield Bad Company demo. Remember demos? That was a thing back in the day, by the way. For the USAS-12, you needed to check your stats on battlefield.com/badcompany. And finally, for the F2000, you needed to become a veteran Battlefield player. All these things are actually fairly simple. They could pretty much all be done by going to the Find All 5 website. But unfortunately, this website was kind of bugged. It didn't perform very well. In fact, this is what you get when you try to visit the site in 2018. Yeah, not gonna happen. So because the Find All 5 website was garbage and nothing really worked, DICE gave out the codes for free for all Bad Company players. With these codes, you can unlock the Find All 5 weapons except for one, the F2000. See, I don't know why, but there was no code for the F2000. To unlock this gun, you still needed to become a Battlefield veteran. And because Battlefield Bad Company 1 was the first Battlefield game on that generation of consoles, you know, the PlayStation 3 and the Xbox 360, nobody was a veteran, at least not on the console. So there were two ways to become a Battlefield veteran at the time and unlock the F2000. So the first way was to go to EA's website, make an EA account and link it to the account on your console. Then you needed to either fill in the code on the back of your, let's say, Battlefield 2 box, for example, and link that older Battlefield title's code to your account. You could also download Battlefield Heroes through this account, so you would be, in essence, you know, a Battlefield veteran. And then link your Battlefield Bad Company 1 code to that website and voila, you are a veteran and now you unlock the F2000. Unfortunately, this was also bugged, so after a short while, this wouldn't work anymore. Now the only other way to unlock the F2000 was to wait a whole year for Battlefield 1943, which was also a console exclusive. Now if you would download this game, technically your account should detect this and give you access to the F2000 when you would return to Bad Company 1. But guess what? This was also bugged, and this was the only other way to get to the F2000. So what does that mean? It means that after this whole mess, nobody in the history of humanity and the entire universe can unlock this gun. Ever. This is in fact the rarest and most exclusive gun in Battlefield history. And it might be even in any other game as well, but I don't know about that. But guys, that's about it for the video. I hope you enjoyed. Since we are on the topic of Battlefield Bad Company 1, some of you might know that I have a Bad Company 1 video ready to be uploaded. I know I've said that for the past month or so, but trust me, this is such an awesome video. I want to upload it at the right time. Anyway, with that being said, leave a like on the video if you enjoyed watching, subscribe with notifications on if you haven't already. Let me know down below in the comments if you guys unlocked any of these guns in this video. Don't bother saying you have unlocked the F2000 in Bad Company 1 because I will never believe you. If you do, however, send me a picture on Twitter and I'm gonna retweet the hell out of it. I wanna see proof because this is the holy grail for me when it comes to exclusive weapons in video games. Anyway, again, thanks for watching. Be sure to be on the lookout for my Bad Company 1 video. It's coming soon, I promise. And with that being said, I see you guys next time.